Hello dear students, today we will discuss the next point in the semiconductor, that is Hall effect. So what is Hall effect? So when a material, usually a semiconductor material in which current flow is there, is subjected to a magnetic field acting at right angles. Semiconducting material, current is flowing and it is subjected to a magnetic field at right angles to the direction of current flow. An electric field is induced across the material in a direction perpendicular to both direction of magnetic field and the direction of current flow. This phenomenon is called Hall effect. So let me explain you what is Hall effect by using this figure. So this is a semiconducting material which is of N type, which has a width W and D is its thickness. So here in this direction the current is flowing. So if you connect a voltmeter across this end and this end, and if you measure, you will find certain voltage, right? So along X coordinate the current is flowing. And if you apply the magnetic field, external magnetic field along the Z coordinate, which is exactly perpendicular to this X, then you will find that an electric field is going to be induced across the upper and the lower surface. So after applying the magnetic field, if you connect a voltmeter across upper and lower surface and measure the voltage, you will find a small potential which was not present before applying the magnetic field. Okay, so this electric field which is going to induce across the material in a direction perpendicular to both the direction of current as well as the direction of the magnetic field is called Hall effect, right? So let me explain you how it is going to happen. Consider a rectangular slab of semiconductor material in which current I is flowing in the positive X direction. As I said, this is a semiconducting material, current is flowing along positive X direction. Let the semiconductor material of N type, which means the charge carriers are electrons. So it is N type of semiconducting material, which means majority charge carriers are the electrons. Let the magnetic field be applied along Z direction. Under the influence of magnetic field, the electrons experience the Lorentz force FL. So when you apply an external magnetic field along the Z direction, which is exactly perpendicular to the X coordinate or the direction of current, then the electrons which are flowing, they will experience a kind of force. They will experience a kind of force, and that force is exerted by the electrons because of Lorentz force FL. And in the PUC you studied Lorentz force, FL is equals to minus of BEV, where B is the magnetic field, E is the charge on electron, and V is the velocity of the electron. So because of this Lorentz force, so from Fleming's left hand rule, we see that force is exerted on the electrons in the negative y direction. So the electrons are moving in this direction, right? So the force is going to be applied by the Lorentz force in the downward direction, so that along the negative of the y axis. So this is the positive y axis, and along the negative of the y axis the force is going to be applied. The electrons are therefore deflected downwards. So when the force is exerted along the negative y coordinate, the electrons will accumulate in the lower base of the semiconducting material. As a result, the density of electrons increases in the lower end of the material. The density of electron increases in the lower end of the material, due to which due to which its bottom edge becomes negatively charged. The bottom edge is going to be negatively charged. The upper end becomes positively charged. When the electrons are stored here, it is going to be negatively charged. As a result, the upper end is going to be positively charged. Hence, a potential VH, a new potential VH, which we will call it as the Hall voltage, appears between the upper and lower surface of semiconductor. That Hall voltage appears upper and the lower surface of the semiconductor. So when you take a semiconducting material in which current is flowing along the x coordinate, when you take an external magnetic field and when you apply it along the z coordinate, right? So the electrons which are flowing in the semiconducting material, they will experience a kind of force which we will call it as the Lorentz force. And because of that Lorentz force, the electrons will be pushed downwards, that is along the negative y-axis. Because of the accumulation of the electrons in the lower surface of the semiconducting material, it is going to be negatively charged, and as a result the upper surface is going to be positively charged. So there will be a kind of potential which is going to be generated on the upper and the lower surface, which we will call it as the Hall voltage. Right, now we will find expression for this Hall coefficient RH. Now for a given semiconductor, the Hall field EH depends upon the current density and applied field. The Hall field is directly proportional to current density and the applied magnetic field. So we can write EH is equals to RH J into B, where RH is the proportionality constant, what we will call it as the Hall coefficient. It will be called as Hall coefficient. So we can write RH is equals to EH divided by GB. So we'll just rearrange this equation. RH is equals to EH divided by GB, where EH, we know that value of EH, Hall field, is B into V, that is magnetic field strength and the velocity of electrons, and J is the current density, is rho into V. So substituting this value, this equation and this equation in the above equation, we will get Hall coefficient, that is RH is equals to B into V divided by rho V into B. So this BV and this BV will get cancelled and you will be getting 1 divided by rho. Hence Hall coefficient RH, the Hall coefficient RH is equals to 1 divided by rho, right? So this is the expression for Hall coefficient. Okay, thank you.